Don Lane Chill TV with, I guess we can't say MP until the election is over, but incumbent Mark Strahl, with the forum today primarily talking about healthcare. We were talking off camera, just in casual conversation about your dad. Seniors came up and senior care. And in the next government, should you form it, what are the Conservatives looking to do when it comes to senior care?
Well, I think for senior care, the number one concern about seniors when they age is that the healthcare system will be there for them when they need it. And so what Andrew Scheer and the Conservatives have proposed is to increase healthcare funding for the provinces every year, a minimum of 3% at least. And so if the provinces know that that money is coming, if they can bank on it, if they can plan for it, they can plan the healthcare system that our seniors have come to grow and rely on. And then we have some other measures that we've announced as well to help seniors keep more money in their pockets by reducing the income that they pay on their pension, or income tax they pay on their pensions, increasing the age credit, removing the GST from things like home heating, eliminating the federal carbon tax. Those are all things that will help seniors across the country save more money so they can look after themselves in their retirement.
We've talked about the opioid crisis in British Columbia. There is a provincial minister for addictions. Would that work on a federal level, or should this still remain more of a provincial jurisdiction?
Well, I think the province is always going to lead on service delivery. That's what our constitution says, and that's the level of government closer to the people generally does a better job of delivering the services. So I think that will continue to be the way that it's delivered. That's not to say that we can't do more when it comes to opioids. 11 people a day are dying from opioid overdose, and not the people that many people think of when they think of a drug user. These are often people that have been professionals that have fallen on hard times and have gotten addicted to opioids. So we need to do a better job at all levels, but I think that the provinces will continue to play a lead role in addressing the addiction crisis.
Mental health issues have been in the forefront for the last couple of years from a lot of initiatives. How can we move this forward? How would the Conservative government, if elected, move that forward?
Yeah, I think we continue to place a priority on the Canadian Mental Health, the Mental Health Association, which we set up when we were in government previously. They've done great work, the Mental Health Commission, I should say. They are leading the research, they are leading the stakeholder engagement. They're working with providers of everything from housing to addiction services, coming up with those federal best practices that can be shared. Mental health affects just about every family. It affects all of our communities, and it impacts so much, whether it's we're talking about seniors care, whether we're talking about PTSD and veterans, whether we're talking about addictions. Mental health is a co-contributor to all of those issues, and until we address that key part of our healthcare system and our own health, I think we'll continue to struggle, spin our wheels to address those other issues. So for me, it's a priority. It's something that I've tried to work hard in our local community and in Ottawa to break down the stigma around mental health, that you are sick, you're not weak, and that you should be treating it like you would treat a high blood pressure. You shouldn't be ashamed of it. You should come forward, and the support should be there when you need them.
At the first all-candidates meeting with Mark Strahl, Don Lane, Chill TV News.